I am sure as a civil engineer you definitely use different type of software for your analysis. It may be STAAD Pro or RISA 3D or something else, and there is nothing wrong in doing so. But if you use them for your design blindly, please hold on. You need to see this video. Hi, I am Tonmoy. Welcome to my channel. If you are a civil engineer and new to this channel, please subscribe to get videos on analysis, design and construction. So, let's get started. Let's say you are analyzing and designing this structure in your software, and this continuous beam is a part of the structure. You have already analyzed it by using your software, and now you are going to run the software for designing this continuous beam. Well, I am telling you, your design result will be wrong. Why? Well, let's see. When you model your structure in your software, you simply put the coordinate corresponding to the center line of any member, right? As a result, you represent this continuous beam in your model by this center line diagram. Agree? Okay. Now, you load it as per your requirement. It may be UDL or point load or something else. And once your modeling is complete, you run your software for analysis. Well, till now everything is okay and your software is also doing great. After analyzing, the software provides you the bending moment and shear force value with 100% accuracy. And I have nothing to comment on that. But if you want your software to design this beam, I am sure you don't know what is going to happen. Let's say you are interested in RCC, that means reinforced concrete construction. Now, consider the blue colored boxed zone, which you are supposed to design by your software. When the software will design this reinforced concrete beam, for bottom reinforced, it will take maximum sagging moment, and for the support, it will take the maximum hogging moment. You may ask, so what is the problem? Yes, there is a problem. The support design is not correct. Definitely, you will ask, why? What is the issue? Well, let's see. Let's place the actual member in this analyzed diagram. There is no question about it that you are interested in designing the beam column junction, as this is the critical section under hogging bending moment. But your software have designed this junction for the moment corresponding to the center line bending moment. So let's have a look how your design is affected for this mistake. Your software designed this beam column junction for moment marked in red color, but the actual moment is much less, which is marked in green color. So your steel consumption become unnecessarily heavy. This is the problem in case of RCC. In case of steel construction, you have to design moment connection for this support moment at beam column junction. You know that any moment is converted into push and pull, and the flanges carry this push pull. If magnitude of the moment is more, this force will also be large for fixed depth of the beam. If you take the center line moment, the value of this tensile force will be large than the actual one, and consequently you need larger diameter bolt or more number of bolt, which is not required actually, as the moment at the face of the column is comparatively less. So your design is not correct. Again, due to the use of center line moment, this compressive force is also become high. So when you check your column for local buckling, maybe the wave of the column is failing because the compressive load is high. So your software will tell you to increase the size of the column or provide doubler plate. Don't worry, I will make video on how to check this column locally and what is doubler plate or how to design it. So as a conclusion, please check manually your design if you done it with your software. For now, that's all. We will meet again in the next video. If you want to see more video like this, you can see the suggested one on the screen. And Please don't forget to subscribe if you have not done it.